You've got it on 2K Sports for Wednesday night action in the NBA. Hi, everyone. Kevin Harlan joined by Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg. Last game for the Pelicans, they picked up a W against the Golden State Warriors.
Yeah, it didn't seem to be much of a challenge for them in that game. It seemed like they scored at will. Not much defense that they were facing.
Yep, they had the defense on its heels early the entire game, and actually nearly the entire game, and no matter what unit was out there, looked like a mismatch to me.
Now, the opening lineup for the New Orleans Pelicans. The backcourt, Holiday and Gordon. Evans and Davis are your small and power forwards. And it's the Prodigy in at the center. Two on the clock. And he makes good on the layup. The Prodigy's got the first points up on the board tonight here for New Orleans. The Grizzlies, grit and grind, know for being old school. Post you up and lock you down type of basketball team.
Yeah, and that front court rotation, boy, the envy of the league, in my opinion. It's a big part of what makes this team really go.
Now here's Randolph, following the miss by Michael Conley over Davis. Evans kicks to Gordon, tries it from nine. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Pelicans will retain possession. Full 24-second shot clock. And about a minute gone here in the first quarter. Evans, good.
The guys for the Grizzlies, a new ownership group, and it seems maybe some tweaks to their identity. They'd look to spread the floor a bit more and pick up the tempo. But the results last season were pretty mixed.
Conley, the pass to Lee. The feed to Gasol. The little runner inside. Al Gordon. He's coming off a 16-point game against Golden State. Kicks to Davis. Baseline Jay on the way. Jump shot is good that time. Davis has got his first bucket of the night.
And, you know, the Grizzlies last season, I thought they did pick up their pace slightly. But they were still a team at the bottom of the league in that regard in terms of fast break points and pace of play. It's really hard to get away from who you've been for so long. This is more of a half-court grinded-out team.
And it's the Pelicans with the ball after the Marcus Onis. From beyond the arc, no good from the Prodigy. The Grizzlies have gone just 1-4 to get this game started. Conley dishes to Gasol, and he gets it to go. Gasol's got his second bucket of the night.
Michael Conley with excellent vision on that pass.
The Pelicans have gone 3-5 shooting the ball so far. Outside Gordon. Evans against Allen. Outside Holiday. Allen with the rebound.
You know, even though he missed that one, great shooters have a way of feeling when they've got enough room to pull the trigger.
Yeah, not enough defensive coverage there to prevent him from firing that time, but I think if he's open, he's got to let that thing fly.
Now Randolph, following Drew Holiday's three-point attempt. Just five on the clock. Conley into the lane, and two free throws coming up as he misses that one, drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there.
Well, you know, for teams in the NBA nowadays, it's all about getting bang for your buck. I mean, Mike Conley out of Ohio State, one of the great value contracts in the league, and with all the analytics and general managers looking for value, Memphis happy to have an all-star caliber still player like him still locked up through 2016.
And he knocks down the first one. And you have to give Mike Conley, Steve, an awful lot of credit for the emergence of the Grizzlies, I think, is a factor in the Western Conference.
Kevin, I think he's one of the best point guards in the league. Probably doesn't get enough credit, but his progression as a player at both ends, year after year, he just seems to get better, and he provides that poise and leadership that his club needs.
And it's tied up with that one. Here's Gordon, averaging 13 points a contest. Goes up to the stripe. And it's off the back rim, no good.
Great defensive anticipation there to challenge that shooter.
Pass to Gasol. Some nice passing there by Memphis. Takes the turnaround J, a rebound by the Prodigy.
And it is very dangerous to leave him open like that. Lucky break for the defense that he missed it.
First quarter of action, just under 3.5 minutes played. Grizzlies have gone 2-6 from the field. Outside Gasol. Courtney Lee is on the wing. The pass to Randall. Takes it into the teeth of the D and converts the layup. The Pelicans have gone 50% from the field to this point. 4 of 8. Evans gets to Holiday. Pass to Davis. To the inside. Stolen by Randolph. Now here's Conley, the fast break opportunity. Lee with the ball. And it's Gordon picking him up. The dish to Allen. Lee passes to Randolph. 5 on the clock. Back to Lee. And it's going to be a 24-second shot clock violation. They turn it over. This is the 2K leaderboard with a rundown of the NBA's top defenders down low. The league's leaders in rejections this month. Take a look at the prodigy. A fierce inside defender. Tops in the NBA in blocks.
I'll tell you what, as the month has unfolded, this guy's defense on the interior has just gotten better and better.
Gordon goes in. The shot misses.
It's the kind of defense required when he's got the ball near the hoop. They were right in his face.
Conley hits to Gasol. Back to Conley. Allen with the screen for Conley. It's Allen on the wing. Gordon against Conley. Knocked loose. Taken away by Holiday. Gordon dishes to Evans. Baseline try. That's good.
That is up-tempo basketball at its best. So much easier to operate in the open court when a steal triggers the break.
Yeah, it really does allow your offense to flow better. When you can get out and run and get easy opportunities, then everybody gains confidence. Let's see the stat sheet here on Tyreke Evans. How last month turned out for him. He's right around 9 points a night, 3 assists and 2 rebounds. And when you take his overall contributions on the whole, he's been putting up some pretty good numbers, but I think he can do more.
And Steve, sometimes that's just part of the game. On the floor.
And here are the Grizzlies now. Trailing by 2. Their last meeting was in New Orleans, where they were unable to fight off the Pelicans.
And it wasn't just bad shooting. I mean, they weren't getting good looks. The offense wasn't clicking, no ball movement, very stagnant performance.
Yeah, I agree. The reason for that, I think, was their movement away from the ball. Not very crisp.
And the Pelicans with possession here. Following the miss by Zach Randolph. Gordon with no one around. Wide open shot is on the money. Gordon's got his first bucket of the night.
Nice pass. He got the ball right into his teammate's shooting pocket. On time and on target.
Inside to Gasol. It's rebounded by the Prodigy. The Prodigy's got rebound number 5 here tonight. Outside Gordon. They set the pick. Again, the Pelicans. Can score.
That's 10 straight points on mid-range jump shots.
You know, the paraphrase a Bible verse that says love covers over a multitude of sins, good shooting does the same thing in basketball.
Now here's Allen. No scoring yet from him, but that's quickly to change. Conley, the pass to Lee. Clock at six. They double-team Randolph. That doesn't go either for Randolph.
It has not been an easy quarter for him, at least offensively speaking.
Evans kicks to Holiday. Shoots the three. It's rebounded by Memphis. Defeated by the Wizards in their last game, they'll try to put that one behind them.
And no matter what they try to do in that loss, Kevin, it just didn't work out for them.
Yeah, to me, it seemed like they kind of gave into it. Like you said, they didn't show too much fight back when it got to double digits, and that's concerning.
Pelicans leading by six. Now we go to Doris Burke, who spoke with head coach Dave Yig. Doris?
One player who's really on his mind in this matchup is Eric Gordon. He said of Gordon, he can shoot with deep range and has the strength and explosiveness to go by you if you overcommit and finish or get himself to the line. So he's just an underrated scorer in this league, and it's going to take a total team effort to slow him down. Kevin, we'll see how they do.
And thank you, Doris. So Memphis going with almost an entire new group here. Kuvis checked in for Gasol. Tolliver comes in for Zach Randolph. Tayshaun Prince has checked in for Lee. Here's Rivers, right now averaging 5 points a game. Pass to the prodigy. No one near him. Kuffis grabs the miss.
Well, you look at Kosta Kuffis, drafted 23rd in 2008 by Utah for just 1 year at Ohio State. Kind of drifted around. Started in Denver. Last season, he played valuable minutes in Memphis when Marc Gasol went out, and I think he's maybe found a home there.
Here's the prodigy. He had 10 points in the win against Golden State. Ashik dishes to Anderson. 1:58 left to play in the first. Kuffis with the block. Here's the prodigy, averaging 19 points per contest. Well, it was only a matter of time, but they finally get the bucket. The prodigy's got 6 points. The Grizzlies trail by six. Clark, they've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a little bit of cotton mouth here. Dry spell for sure.
Tolliver the pass to Udrich. He kicks it to Prince. Just four to shoot. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him.
And no question, he got bumped on that shot.
Definitely no room for discussion on that one.
And a look at how the hustle game has been going for New Orleans.
You know, they've done a great job of getting a hand up on shooters.
Good work. Good work.
Oh, yeah, man.
They're causing turnovers, and that's allowing them to get into transition.
Fredette, he's checked in for the prodigy. one is no good.
Right from the start, they've been aggressive on the glass. Most of the rebounds seem to be going their way.
And, Steve, I think they are ready for the fight today.
And that one's good. Anderson's got his first 3 points of the game.
They really can't allow him too many open looks like that. I mean, that's just inviting trouble.
55 seconds left here in the first quarter. And Udrich with almost an entire new group here. Marc Gasol has checked in for Kupis. Randolph comes in for Anthony Taliaferro. Lee's checked in for Tony Allen. And Mike Conley subbed in for Udrich. Prince is the three and Randolph the four. Conley and Lee, they're the backcourt. And it's Gasol. And at the pivot spot, man. The middle. That's the lineup in the game for Memphis. The Grizzlies trail by three. Outside Conley. Loses his man off the screen. And it up and in.
You know, the height difference there is huge, but he canceled it out with great body control in the air.
Exactly, Steve. He got to the hoop and wouldn't allow himself to be manhandled by the big boy.
Here's the prodigy. 6 points for him, and that one's good. The prodigy's got 8 points.
Looked like the defense kind of backed off him, and he took advantage.
Grizzlies have gone 4 of 7 from the field in this second quarter so far. Feeds to Randolph. A jump hook, and that one falls, coming off Conley's feet. Randolph's got his second basket of the game. The Pelicans shooting 48% from the field. Not bad at all. And Holiday, here we go. Another one falls for New Orleans.
How about that? Gets it off right in the face of the big fella. Quick release.
And operating on the perimeter like that negates some of the height disadvantage, too.
Now here is Conley. 14 points from him the last game against Washington.
And with 3 steals, he also showed some grit and toughness at the defensive end.
Here's Randolph. It's tipped. Gasol. Great D that time from Davis.
They've been strong on the boards. There's no disputing that.
That's what the box score says. Still anybody's game, though.
Back to Evans. Some nice passing here by New Orleans. Gordon goes in, and it's rejected. Holiday against Conley. Into Marc Gasol. Here's Randolph, and terrific work on the offensive glass, and he picks up 2. Randolph's got 6.
But the defense just looked a little lazy on the glass there.
Yeah, nobody boxing out. That's inexcusable.
The drive by Gordon. And misses it off the right side of the rim.
And he continues to search for his rhythm. It's eluded him to this point.
Randolph dishes to Conley. Prince with a screen on Holiday. Here's Conley, and he comes off the screen to bury the jump shot. He has 6.
Defense just has to fight over the top of those screens.
Especially when the ball is in his hands. I mean, he doesn't miss too many open shots.
Now here's Gordon. Evans attacking. Back to Gordon. This one for 3. Gasol with the block, and he gets it back. Gordon with another miss.
And it seems like nothing is falling for him this quarter. He's really out of his rhythm.
Gasol setting the pick for Conley. Dishes to Gasol. Wide open. Gasol missing again. New Orleans has gone 0-3 from beyond the arc to start the second quarter. Davis with it. He's picked up by Lee. Here's the prodigy. Fades. That one goes. Count it. The prodigy's got 10.
He's created some good opportunities for himself and made the most of them.
While we're in this quick break and onto the small forward position and the hottest shooters among them over the last month. Tyreek Evans, number one.
And when you've got a player like him who can shoot that well, not at center, but at small forward, it gives you a remarkably dependable option every time down the floor.
That is so true, Steve. From 5 feet, 10 feet, 20 feet, his touch is really on target.
The Grizzlies have gone 7-13 from the field since the start of the second. Holiday against Conley. Fades away. Goes back up. Got hit. Some solid defense there from the prodigy. Evans outside. Tries to keep it alive. And that's out of bounds. New Orleans will retain possession.
And with a quick chance here, let's take a look now at some of the numbers for Drew Holiday. He's getting around 12 points a game, 6 assists, and 3 rebounds. And I think the playmaking really stands out to me that he's been doing it. So many times the plays he can generate seem to change the momentum of a game.
I agree wholeheartedly there. I mean, it's underestimated what his passing brings to this team.
Now Conley. Following Drew Holiday's three-point attempt. Conley with it, and it's Gordon picking him up. And it's out of bounds. The Grizzlies able to retain possession here.
And now we get a chance to see how the Grizzlies are doing in the NBA rankings right now. First in opponent field goal percentage. Second in rebound. And they kept the lid on opposing teams. Overall offense as well. They're in the top 10 in opponent scoring.
Hey, Clark, let's talk about that defense. I mean, number one in the league in field goal percentage. You talked about it. They're just smothered. They really get after you. They try to attack you. They close out. They rotate well, and they're constantly covering up for one another.
Now Randolph following Drew Holiday's three-point attempt. Just 5 to shoot. Here's Lee. And he hits it just before the shot clock expires. Lee's got the lead up to 1 now for the Grizzlies. The Pelicans have gone 6-14 shooting here in the second. And Doris Burke has something for us. Hey, Doris.
Well, gentlemen, Anthony Davis is not yet a household name, but he's quickly becoming an elite talent. Coach Monty Williams said there are a few power forwards that are rated ahead of him, but the key is winning. When we win, people are going to see how much better he is than those guys. He's right there with the best in the league. Such a bright young career, Kevin.
A superstar in the making, Doris. Thank you. The Grizzlies making a switch here. Allen's checked in. Ryan Anderson, he's checked in for the Pelicans. Holiday, the pass to Gordon. Holiday with it. Conley picks him up. Passes it to the prodigy. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for 2. It's going to be on Zach Randolph.
He's been absolutely in control. No slowing down for the prodigy. 8 rebounds, and he's been a brick wall today with all those blocks.
Has he ever. And he's really making them think twice about bringing the ball into the middle.
This New Orleans team is now in their second season as the Pelicans. The name, which was subject to some critique early on, has actually turned out to be nice for the franchise with a new group of players, new ownership, and it fits nicely into creating a new identity.
When you talk about the Pelican mascot, Steve, Wingspan, a term that definitely applies to this team and the young Anthony Davis.
Yeah, it's a great name. You know, Davis was last year's leading shot blocker to go with 20 points and 10 boards a game. I mean, this guy is a potential superstar and obviously the key for this club moving forward. You know, he started out hot and he's only gotten hotter. He could be in for one of those games.
The Grizzlies trail by three. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've had a number of empty ones, a long time without a basket.
I got to find something, you're right. Outside Conley, he feeds it to Randolph. He dishes it to Gasol, six to shoot. And that's collected by the Prodigy. The Prodigy's got nine rebounds in the game, getting it done. Fades and shoots. Goes back up, and there's the play by Anderson inside. Anderson's got nine.
It took him a little while to get into the flow of this game, but now he's definitely found his stride and rhythm.
Outside Conley. And there's the feed to Lee. And again, Memphis no good. Pelicans leading by five. Here's Evans, and the bucket counts, and he's on his way to the free throw line. Try to make it a three-point play.
Nice shooting.
They can't just keep allowing.
So we've reached the end of the first half of play. Pelicans on top, up nine. And now we'll send it down to Doris Burke, who's standing by courtside.
Well, a double-double already in the books for you, and we're only at the half. Do you see them trying to throw different looks at you to slow you down?
Yeah, I expected they might. But at the same time, we're going to have an answer for that because the rest of this team, this dangerous on the offense is me.
Thank you for your time, Kevin. If it ain't broke, don't fix it.
Thank you, Doris. And we'll be back after halftime for the start of the second half.
All right, men. We've done a good job in the first half of taking the momentum and being assertive with our style of play.
I like the number of points we got in transition, and I wouldn't mind seeing even more activity on the break. Let's keep the tempo quick, guys. One place we've had success was in the low post on offense. Great positioning. Good job finding the open passing lanes and getting the ball in tight. Also, we can sacrifice some manpower on the defensive glass in this half in order to have opportunities to get the break started with bodies already headed up the court.
All right, we're in good shape, but this is a strong team we're up against. We're going to have to weather some storms in the second half. Come on, fellas, we got this.
While we've got a moment, let's set the floor. Brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up for the second half. So for New Orleans right now, Gordon is the two with Evans playing small forward. Prodigy is out there with Davis, and it's Holiday in at the one.
That's like a layup for him. He's just wide open out there.
Pelicans leading by six. Now the pass to the Prodigy. Another shot, and Davis lays it in.
They've been the glass eaters today, guys. A ton of effort out of them down low.
And they've needed every one of those rebounds. I think that's what's put them in front here.
You have to wonder, it's certainly worth thinking about with the way Anthony Davis took a big step forward last year. There's a legitimate argument or discussion anyway that he might eventually become the best player in the league at some point.
It's good. From the Prodigy. And if you're just joining us, we played over a minute here in the third. Allen gets to Conley. Gasol, a screen on Holiday. Lee, left side. No good. And New Orleans will come the other way. Next matchup, they'll be home against the Suns. That game is the first and last of their homestand.
I'll be looking forward to seeing how that Phoenix game turns out for sure.
The Grizzlies trail by 11. Here's Allen. Evans with the rebound. Evans has got his third rebound tonight. Pass to the Prodigy. Davis with a screen on Gasol. In the corner, it's Gordon. Gets it to go from beyond the arc. They got on this roll a while ago, and they just haven't looked back. And we're just about 2 minutes into the second half now. Here's Conley. Drops it in from 11 feet. Conley's got 8 points.
It's a good thing he showed up today, because without him, this team would be in big trouble.
Holiday, the pass to the Prodigy. And that is good.
That is some real serious dime dropping there. Exquisite assist.
The Grizzlies have gone 2-4 here to start the second half. Conley gets to Gasol. Lee dishes to Randolph. Lets it go from the wing. Misses off the left iron.
An 8-rebound advantage like the one they have now is always going to swing the score hard in that team's direction.
And that's certainly been the case today. Their rebounding has made a huge difference.
Davis kicks to Evans. New Orleans moving the ball around. Here's the Prodigy. He goes up again, and it's good on the layup. The Prodigy's got 21.
They're forcing the ball inside, and it's working beautifully.
Yeah, the defense has been futile here. 5 of the last 6 field goals in the lane.
Moment to check in with Doris Burke. Doris?
During that break, Coach Dave Yeager had some words for his team. He told them they should be dedicating themselves to hitting the offensive glass with everything they've got from now on. It means it takes them away from defensive transition. The second thing he got into with them regarded getting the ball into the post, saying, quote, the passing lanes will be open for us. We have to use that to our advantage and get the ball inside. Well, they need to make something happen before the start of the fourth quarter, and maybe those changes will do the trick, Kevin.
And as always, Doris. Thank you. On offense, here are the Pelicans. It's a 12-2 run here. Good pace. And that's Evans penetrating. Got that bucket in no time at all. Evans has got 8 points.
Well, this is what happens when he gets on a roll. You are not going to see a better rhythm shooter than him.
Well, good teams tend to have a defined style of play. Steve, the Grizzlies had grit and grind, but it seems they're going away from it now.
Kind of a throwback style, Kevin, but it suited their personnel perfectly, particularly with Randolph and Gasol down low. The slower pace lent itself to better defense for them, and they really pounded you inside, that's for sure.
Here's the prodigy, and it's New Orleans scoring again.
Really hard to find fault with anything he's doing this quarter, at least at the offensive end.
The Grizzlies trail by 20. They really want to find that igniter here.
Yeah, that's right. Kevin, the offense has basically been running in place.
They got to get going. Kicks to Lee. Randolph, a screen on Gordon. Shot clock at 5. Lee passes to Connor. From outside, off the mark.
And, you know, the Grizzlies got swept in the Western Conference Finals back in 2013 because the Spurs just packed it in defensively. And I really think that was the impetus for the Grizzlies looking to try to play a more wide-open style. You know, even though that season in 2013 was, as a whole, the best ever for the franchise, it did expose their weaknesses and gave them something to work on.
Shot to end this cold run, and it's Randolph getting it to go. Randolph's got 8.
Well-executed possession. They controlled the shot. Nicely done.
Gordon dishes to Holiday. Trying to find Davis. He's got it now. Evans kicks to Gordon. Fires for 3. Lee with the block. An even 3-on-3 break. Here's Conley. Count the bucket, coming off a perfectly placed assist. He's got 10.
Boy, the floor really opened up for him there.
It sure did. A good job getting it started before the defense can get itself set.
And last season, it took the Grizzlies some time to get going. The new head coach, the injury to Marc Gasol, but they added some shooting and athleticism on the wings and really rallied strongly towards the end of the year.
New Orleans needs to get off a shot. And play stops as it looks like they call him over the back here.
Not much doubt about that over the back call.
Yeah, he was all over his back that time. Looked like he was going for a piggyback ride.
So Memphis going with almost an entire new group here. Kuvis checked in for Gasol. Tolliver comes in for Zach Randolph. Tayshaun Prince has checked in for Courtney Lee. And it's Udrich in for Mike Conley.
Well, he hasn't had much success shooting the ball, but it's not too late for him to get it turned around and start contributing. Great interplay there between those two teammates.
The Grizzlies trail by 18. Udrich, the pass to Kuffis. Prince against Anderson. Prince dishes to Tolliver. Allen outside. Here's Prince. Finds the bottom of the bucket from 13 feet out. And here are the Pelicans now. Holiday, the pass to the prodigy. Anderson kicks to Selmans. New Orleans moving the ball around. Oshik with the bucket.
Very well done that time. Found the best look possible.
Memphis has gone 1-3 from downtown since halftime. Udrich dishes to Kuffis. Pass to Udrich. It's Kuffis atop the key. Prince outside. Nice jump shot. Good. Prince has got 5 now. Pelicans leading by 16.
Well, Kosta Kuffis was a player the Grizzlies had coveted for a couple of seasons. They ended up trading Darrell Arthur for him. And I like what they got. A starting caliber center, a good value on his contract, excellent defender. Really good trade for Memphis.
Holiday brings the double team. Udrich, the pass to Prince. The dish to Allen. Expanding his range. The rebound by the prodigy. The Prodigy's got rebound number 15 here tonight.
Well, they've been better than good on the glass today. There's a glaring discrepancy between these teams in that area of the game.
Yeah, and that's what's paved the way for them to build this big lead, no question.
Yeah. The floater tries again. Tolliver, no luck. New Orleans gone into the three-point range four times since halftime and buried two of them. And Holiday kicks to Selmans. And again, no good by New Orleans.
You know, even though he missed that three-point shot, I think the defense has to do a better job of challenging the shot.
Yeah, because you know if you continue to give up open looks like that, you're in big trouble.
Allen with another miss.
Kevin, not a single point in this quarter for him. Obviously, not what they need right now. He's got to score.
Here's the prodigy. It's good, the assist that time. From Holiday. 26 points for the prodigy.
Well, they're in great position here, and it's thanks in large part to their three-point shooting.
You called that right. They are lighting it up from behind the arc this half.
Feeds it to Tolliver. Tried to come right back with a three of his own, but it's no good. Here's the prodigy. 26 points for him. Selmans dishes to Holiday. Just five on the clock. Here's Anderson. And again, New Orleans with the triple.
That is a real nice-looking deep three ball there, fellas.
Boy, shooting the ball with major confidence.
Now Udrich. He's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. He kicks it to Tolliver. Kufis cleans up the mess with the savage putback flush.
That kind of putback turns a simple rebound into a highlight play.
He assaulted the glass, you're right, then assaulted the rim.
Yeah, now that's getting the job done on the boards.
And at the end of the third quarter, a huge lead, and this one may already have been decided. Pelicans ahead, opening up a huge gap. Live from the FedEx Forum, you're watching 2K Sports.
Coming up this Friday, April 10th, Goran Dragic and the Phoenix Suns go up against Anthony Davis and the New Orleans Pelicans, a conference battle in the West. Do not miss.
Pelicans leading by 23. Zebo and Marc Gasol are up front. Lee and Price are out in the wings. And it's Conley in at the point. That's the lineup in the game for Memphis. And here are the Grizzlies. It's off to Utah for them after this game as they take on the Jazz. That's game one of a three-game road trip. Here's Gasol. That's in there. Conley with the assist. Conley's got assist number five here tonight.
Beautiful dish down low.
The Pelicans shooting 52% from the floor. Nice work so far from them. Here's the prodigy. Another one falls. For New Orleans.
They've built this lead through plays exactly like that. He's easily been their most consistent performer.
Well, he's been splashing everything today.
Poked loose. Left side, Gordon. And that's out of bounds. New Orleans will retain possession. Some changes for Memphis. Hamilton's checked in for Gasol. For Zach Randolph. And it's Pondexter in for Tayshaun Prince. New Orleans also making some changes with... He's checked in for Anderson. Darius Miller comes in for Tyreek Evans. And it's Rivers in for Gordon. Here's Withy. Dishes it to Fredette. Five on the clock. Unloads from 13. Here's the prodigy, covered by Conley. Stolen by Michael Conley. Now here's Conley, the fast break opportunity, and the whistle blows. It's going to be on Michael Conley. That is his first foul of the game.
Great defense. He anticipated the play and got
dialed in from long range. I like it.
Saul's checked in for Hamilton. Randolph comes in, and Tayshaun Prince subbed in for Quincy Pondexter. The Pelicans have gone 5 of 12 from the field entering the fourth quarter. Rivers passes to Withy. He feeds it to Fredette.
Well, in these games late in the season, you know, critics say sometimes that motivation can be lacking. Playoff teams may be resting their stars. But it's...
Grizzlies making a switch. Calathis has checked in. The prodigy has checked in for the Pelicans. And for Memphis, they're shooting just 39% from the field, struggling to find that net. Conley up top. He's guarded by Rivers. Conley's shot is off. Steve, you mentioned the dog days of March and in April. How would the league make winning more important, Clark, down the stretch?
Well, I've heard a number of interesting ideas. A play-in tournament for the final playoff spot, giving teams a few days of rest prior to the playoffs, eliminate mid-lottery protection so there's not an all-or-nothing losing incentive. The biggest thing to me would be reducing the number of regular season games.
Yeah, and you think that might happen?
I would love to see it happen. I don't think it will, though.
Rivers against Conley. Passes it to the prodigy. Down to five on the shot clock. and he was fouled in the act of shooting. Chance here now for a three-point play.
How about that play? Great body control, still manages to finish the play despite the contact.
You know, when that whistle blows, you're not done. Get greedy and find a way to knock it down.
In a moment now to quickly take a look at the offensive approach for the Pelicans.
They've knocked down plenty of mid-range jumpers in this one. That's been big for them.
And they continue to knock down the long-range three-point shot as well.
Free throw good from the Prodigy.
It took some time, and fans might have been unsure for a while, but clearly the Pelicans have a direction for this team now, and I think they're a franchise on the rise.
And there's the feed to Calathes. Will it go? Randolph can't hit. New Orleans has gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. Miller, the pass to the Prodigy. No good from outside.
And with the Pelicans getting a franchise big like they did with Davis always helps, but they're also active in acquiring talent to grow around them. Intelligent passing there to make that hoop possible.
For New Orleans, they've gone 7-15 from the fourth. Here in the fourth, right around 46-47%. Here's Withy, no luck. Now Memphis takes it the other way. For the Pelicans, getting young talent is one thing, and they want to make sure Clark. That they got the right talent to fit alongside their star.
Kevin, I really think sometimes the cohesiveness and the fitting of the parts is overlooked. Undervalued, and the Pelicans are trying to make that a real priority. Not only do we want talent, but we want it to fit together nicely, and you've got to give them kudos for that.
That's a good point. The three. Prince misses. New Orleans dictating the flow. Rivers kicks to Miller.
Well, a new award in the NBA starting two seasons ago, the Twyman Stokes Best Teammate. And the first honoree was Chauncey Billups.
Withy gets the bucket.
Gotta love the use of the bounce pass there. Perfect feed.
Grizzly shooting under 40% all in all for the game. And it's Conley penetrating. Prince outside, pulls up, and Zach Randolph gets the whistle that time. That'll be his second foul of the game. Some changes for Memphis. Kubis checked in for Gasol. Tolliver comes in for Tayshaun Prince, and it's Udrich in for Mike Conley. The Pelicans also changing it up. Ashik comes in for Withy, and it's Selman's in for Miller. And the names of that award memorializes the incredible story of Jack Twyman and Maurice Stokes. Stokes, an NBA All-Star in each of his first three seasons, but in a game in 1958, he took a hard fall, hit his head, and thereafter became paralyzed.
One of the saddest and most moving stories in the history of sports. Stokes was waived by the team, and his family couldn't afford his gigantic medical bills, but his teammate, Jack Twyman, worked tirelessly on his behalf. A tremendous story of love, caring,
and service in a tough situation.
All game long, guys, he's been getting it done, really doing a nice job rebounding.
Yeah, I couldn't agree with you more. I mean, they've had a major advantage on the glass, dominating that stat.
Here's the prodigy. Again, the Pelicans score.
He's been working some magic out there today, guys. This lead has been largely his making.
Here's Calathes. He dishes it to Udrich. 2 minutes. That's good.
Well, he wasn't fazed at all by the bigger man on him, and on the low block, I thought he might be.
You know, Steve, I thought maybe he'd prefer to bring him out to the perimeter, but whatever works, go to it.
Rivers dishes to Selmans. Inside. Here's the prodigy. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
You know, the Grizzlies are the kind of team that perhaps fans around the league can overlook or undervalue or even forget about at times, but they're always going to be there because they're tough, they're physical, and they're talented.
Well, guys, as you were talking about, Memphis not a big-budget franchise or one with a history that runs so deep that often fans overlook them.
That may be true, but it's given the Grizzlies a very underdog attitude that I think the franchise and the team and the fans have embraced.
Both free throws good from the prodigy.
Well, you know, as teams become more and more focused on getting good looks in close at the rim, the value of great defensive big men inside just continues to rise. I mean, it's tough to be a contender without a rim protector.
There's the pick. The pass to Tolliver. The tray. That's good. And it's Udrich with the assist that time. Udrich has got his fourth assist in this one.
And so it's going to end up in the record books as a blowout, dominating performance for the Pelicans.
Clark, the biggest factor tonight had to be their great shooting. They shot much better than the other team.
You know, I thought both teams worked hard at both ends, but sky-high field goal percentage and pressure defense to force the other team into a lot of misses. Excellent effort tonight.
And this will now push it to a total of 44 games in the win column on the season.
This will be their third win in four tries against this team. Not too shabby.
To say the least, you could see how much they wanted this win. For two very familiar opponents, a win in the season series carries a lot of extra weight.
Well, you look back at this one, and what an amazing performance this has been for the prodigy. He was extremely efficient offensively, getting looks, knocking down big shots all game long.
It's rebounded by Memphis. And with the new camera... systems, it's easier to measure defense, going beyond block shots to look at which, for instance, big men diminish shooting percentages in their area.
Yeah, no surprise. I mean, names like Dwight Howard, Roy Hibbert, Serge Ibaka. But interesting that that reputation has value defensively when players hesitate to go inside.
Guys, he's actually indefatigable. He never gives in, never gives up on a play, and that's what it takes to be a great offensive rebounder. You've got to be relentless.
Here's Rivers, and the layup is good.
Well, the fans already heading for the exits, clearly not pleased with the way their home team played here today.
And they shouldn't be pleased. I mean, it's a very well-deserved win, Steve. They came into this building and weren't intimidated at all. They were the aggressors.
Off the screen. Offline. So we see the Pelicans taking the W here. You know, Clark, every team has a bad night, and these guys might want to watch the tape of this game the next time they have a bad night to remind themselves how dominant they can be.
Well, this is one of those dreamlike games for a coach.
And a chance now to send you over to Doris Burke, standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Well, the outcome of this one never really in doubt tonight. Would you say that this is one of the better performances by this team this year?
As of now, I say yeah, but I know in a few weeks that won't be the case because we'll probably be setting records by beating teams by like 100 points or something. And you know I'll be leading the way on that one.
Well done. Kevin, a young man always looking for more.
Thanks a lot, Doris. And that'll do it for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke. This is Kevin Harlan saying so long and thanks for joining us as we leave you with the Jordan player of the game.
Okay, Kelly in front. What do you got?
During the team's current winning streak, how concerned have you been with making sure you get yours?
Hey, I get buckets. Straight buckets, all right? Anything else is uncivilized.
Your question, Chris?
You were a beast on the boards tonight. Was it frustrating that your teammates weren't pulling their weight?
We were all out there working, man. I mean, the ball just happened to be bouncing my way. That happens sometimes. There's no need to make a big deal out of it.
You, sir.
Everyone's talking about your little social media snafu. Care to comment?
No comment. I like to keep that private.
Private? That's a good one. Maybe you should have thought about that before blasting your intentions to lead the team to the universe.
You know what? You live and you learn, so let's move on.
Move on to the next team, most likely.
Hey, listen, I'm not apologizing for being a self-advocate.
Self-advocate? Is that what the selfish kids are calling themselves these days?
Hey, if that's what you want to call being selfish, hey, then I'm selfish, all right? That's what's helped me ignore the critics and the naysayers, all the people that didn't believe that I'd be where I am right now. I apologize for absolutely nothing.
All right, thanks, everybody. We're done here. You know what? How about me?
What about you?
You apologize to me?
For what?
For cleaning up your mess. Again.
Man, girl, please.
So with this social media scandal thing going, you've alienated your teammates, the fans, and management.
That wasn't my intention.
But that's what happened. That's why I keep an extra cell at home just for conversations I want to keep to myself. And that bad boy never leaves the house.
An extra cell?
Just keep your intentions to yourself. We're all disposable in this league. All I really care about is your mindset. How you feeling?
I feel like I gotta make sure I take care of number one. I mean, even you said it yourself. We all disposable in this league. I could tear my ACL tomorrow, and my time in this league could be over. So I got to make sure that I take ownership of my life, my career, and make some money while I can.
I can respect that. I can. But just know that attitude is going to affect relationships with the organization, the fans, but most importantly, your teammates. And they have to know that you're still a professional and are willing to take care of business here. Do you think you can do that?
Man, they all know, once I put that uniform on, that I'm selling out for them every night.
Good. Then roll out of here.
Man, you got it.